Okay, so just taking a quick look at the first three of these. We'll just look at the first three, actually, of these economy picking exercises. They kind of single out the ones that are a problem, you know, the hard parts of these, to kind of section them out into small exercises. The first one is kind of like a mix between inside picking and outside picking. There's nothing really economy picking about it. It's just kind of, it's the practice pick planting, really, you know. It's almost impossible to see it, but it's kind of a feel thing. Like you're just picking two notes, you know. So you're kind of going outside. Then change to inside. The second kind of exercise is the same kind of thing, only you're doubling up on one string. And then the next exercise is kind of the same thing again, when you're doubling on both strings. So you're kind of... Very, very tricky. It's very tricky because you almost have to have the plectrum sitting on the string before you play it, so you have to really consciously kind of get to it, you know. It's tricky. Other ones then, I suppose I might as well show you the other two, is kind of like going along three strings. And I think it's the same again, only a double on one string. Obviously that's not it, because I shouldn't be letting that string ring out. Okay, so another thing actually that I'm going to try and put into kind of some of the practice every week. I'm kind of all over the place. I haven't actually done this, so it's really what I'm trying to put in and hopefully have it kind of together for next week or whatever. Is maybe two sequences every couple of months, or every couple of weeks. When we're talking about every couple of months, well, that feels like it's every couple of months anyway. Yeah, so this is one particular one. They're all pentatonic sequences based on that. Economy picking. Is it economy? I can't remember. Economy picking is kind of sweet picking. Hybrid picking. tricky to kind of keep that clean. I really have to work on that. Never know whether to use a nail or not a nail, because I don't really want to use a nail, so I need to get my finger used to doing that. Anyway, we'll get back to some more stuff anyway later. Right, house to myself again. Craig's in college. Jaden's in school. Jenny's gone out. She's off today. Now, I've got to come in here and there's a guy interested in this voodoo valve and that MIDI board. I have to log in and see if he's organized, collected yet. I have some vlog stuff to do. I think this week we'll go over this stuff, maybe later. And last week I kind of didn't go over much of this this picking stuff. I think we'll do that this week. We need to move on in a few of these too. We're gonna be kept busy. Right, let's go and do it. Alright, so what's the deal with the rack, James? Well, really, the plans for this rack is to be able to use these preamps. Now, I got rid of the voodoo valve. I just stuck this pitch rack in, which is a kind of a pitch shifter. That needs to be repaired, actually, so it's not even working. I think there's an internal battery gone or something. It's making all sorts of funky noises. The idea is to be able to switch between preamps. So I've got the JMP1 here and the MP1. There's a Mesa Boogie Studio Pre, which I'm after getting as well. I have yet to collect. And between those three preamps, anyway, I want to be able to switch between, have some sort of effects, and then out to my power amp, you know. Now, to be able to do that, I need to have a loop switcher, obviously, and so that's what I'm after getting. I've bought a loop switcher, a power station, and a stereo line mixer. Now, I have kind of no clue how this whole thing works. I'm only kind of figuring it out as I'm going along, so to think that I know what I'm talking about would be, it would be not accurate. I understand the loop switcher all right, that makes sense. The stereo line mixer, I'm not actually sure what it's for at all, haven't a clue really. I know it's for balancing, probably wet and dry signal, I don't know, I'm not quite sure. Power station is pretty obvious anyway, so I mean, if you're not using something like this, I have this, it's kind of an effects unit. It has reverb, delay, chorus, all sorts of kind of cool kind of stuff in it. But I had problems with it because it's so complicated to get it working. I could get it working with the MP1, no problem. But for the JMP1, for some reason, it just was clashing with sounds. When I bring in the effect and bring the volume in on the effect, it just was giving me grief. It was almost as if the dry signal from this was mixing with wet and dry signal from here, and so when the two dry signals got together, it kind of muddied up everything and made it sound terrible. I need to just have this strictly wet and this strictly dry, obviously, and be able to just bring it in. Maybe the stereo line mixer does that kind of stuff, I don't know. Anyway, so there's three rack units. Well, there's four rack units yet to come, actually. The Mesa Boogie Pre, which will go somewhere there or whatever. And then there's three other units. So you've got the looper, the line switcher, and the power station. The power station I'm interested in because I'm not going to use a rack mounted effect in this. What I'll do is I'll have a double tray. Obviously, this unit is not big enough. I'm going to have to get a bigger case. But what I'll have is a double tray, and the effects I'm really only bothered with is reverb and delay, really. You know, I'm not really pushed about anything else. I will get something else that's kind of like a multi kind of pedal, you know, that'll have a bit of everything in it, chorus and that kind of stuff, and be able to have my sounds in among all that stuff, like, you know, with all the loops. Basically, the MP1 I want to use for clean sound. Maybe two clean sounds out of that, that are real, you know, they're real 80s kind of clean sounds. And the chorus that's in this, if I'm ever using chorus or whatever, I'll be using it in this unit. The Studio Pre, which will be there, will more or less be used for kind of Fenderish kind of cleans. You know, that's the idea for that one. And this I'll use for kind of overdrives and, you know, kind of lead sounds or heavy distortion. Eventually I want to get a Soldano SP77, which could probably replace the Mesa Boogie Pre. But anyway, I want to be able to switch between them and have an option of having each sound with reverb, each sound with a bigger reverb, each sound with reverb and delay, and each sound with reverb and a bigger delay. And with the option of adding in an extra effect on top of that as well. I don't even know if that's fucking possible. I'm sure it is. But I'm assuming what I'm getting will be able to handle what I need to do. It could be a complete nightmare. It might be a complete disaster, you know. But anyway, I will be going through. I might actually make separate videos, especially for this rack setup, because I really don't know what I'm doing. And, you know, I suppose it would be beneficial if I actually made a kind of a little series about it, because I'm really going to be jumping into it and it's going to be seriously head-wrecking. And I know a lot of people out there would like to get involved with rack stuff, but are just kind of confused with it, you know. The whole idea about just the pedal tray here is that I can take that pedal tray out with the loop switcher and the power station and have it in a separate unit as well, and have it for my my Fender Supersonic 22 or even Fender Bass Breaker over there. Just be able to have those effects so I can take them out of the rack. Is that feasible? I don't know. It's obviously not, because they're going to be fucking heavy and stuff like that, so I don't know. Anyway, there will be a lot more about this over the next couple of weeks, but for now, we're taking a break from this and it won't be mentioned again. Anyway, okay. Alright, stuck painting today. I've got to get that bathroom upstairs done. Everybody's out doing their stuff. I'm at the top of the stairs there. I've just run over these licks last night to see which one needs work or whatever. And 8 and 9 I kind of want to get into over the next 2 or 3 days, so that could be kind of done. I've already showed you kind of some of them, so yeah, there's nothing else to do really. I have to just kind of wait now for more paint to arrive. I'm in my painting gear. So, right, yeah, get back to you in a while. The beauty of a flat roof. I love the sound of that. I reckon this would make a really good meme. I should have bought that goddamn Charvel. Eating your dinner.
Talk you.
Are you gonna eat your dinner?
Talk you.
Go on, show me how you. How do you take a bite out of that? Show me. Let me see.
Quick.
I want to
open this.
Quick.
Come on, but Daddy's gonna show Granda this.
Good boy.
I'd go upstairs for a minute and get your car seat as well.
Right. Kind of at a juncture here now this morning. I've got a mountain of stuff to do, and then I've got nothing to do. This is the first morning that I've walked in here that it is actually very cold. This is a problem that I have every year. This room just gets unbelievably cold during winter because, I mean, it's three outside walls. Those three walls are outside walls, and they're not insulated. So that means I have to start moving guitars now that I don't want kind of damaged and stuff like that, paintwork and that kind of thing. So usually I only have one or two guitars down here anyway, so I think I may start moving some. Right, I'm in two minds whether to actually go back to bed, which I really want to do right now, or whether I'm just going to get my stuff done, and I really need to shower and shave, and I've got stuff to do uptown, and Jaden is kind of sick again today, so I can imagine he's probably going to be sent home early. So if I had any sense at all, I'd actually do these things now so that I'd have some sort of a chance of doing stuff later, or I could just go back to bed for 2 hours. And the last option is really calling me right now. But anyway, I said I'd just make some coffee and see how I feel after that. And that's it. I still have some painting to do. I have some of the edges and stuff to do when I get back to it up there. But anyway, right, let's see how we get on. Okay, so I'm just kind of finished up, kind of just messing about, and I'm about to head to bed. Got a little bit of guitar done this evening. I kind of ran over some of the licks, and just kind of looking at the ones that I need to, really kind of practice and brush up on. I have to organise the backing tracks for that, because it's kind of counterproductive playing along to the lick, because you're kind of hiding your own, I keep saying this, you're hiding your own mistakes, you're kind of out in the open when you're playing with the backing track, so you can actually hear properly. Anyway, Jaden went to the hospital then this evening because he was in severe pain all day in school and then back here because he hasn't gone to the toilet at all. He was due to kind of go today and he kind of didn't go, so he had to have a Microlax, which is kind of like a mini enema. Is the word I'm trying to use. It's supposed to kind of give them the urge to go. But he had to get two of them today because he goes crazy, obviously, when he has to get one. He goes insane, actually. So he struggled around so much that the first one was kind of useless, so he had to have a second one. He still didn't go. He went about 3 hours later. But when he did go then, there was a lot of blood in it and all sorts of stuff, he's doing serious damage to himself by not actually going. So anyway, they went over to A&E with him this evening, he has to stay there tonight, and he was going to do some scans on him tomorrow and a couple of different things. So Jetty stayed over there tonight, so I'll probably have to stay over there tomorrow night if he's kept in again. I can't see him being kept in again. I'd say they're just keeping him in for some tests to do tomorrow. But so he's over there tonight, so I have the place to myself. So, and even though I do have the place to myself and I can play guitar now late into the night, I'm just shattered. I just can't concentrate for more than about 2 or 3 minutes. Right, leave it at that. See you tomorrow. Alright, so I'm just getting a few things together here before I head over to the hospital to Jenny and Jaden.
But there are other people who, they just want to get away from the scene, but then present to hospital.
There's another terrorist attack in London there. Just stuck on Sky News a second ago, I just heard about it. Guy should be coming to collect this today, so I'm not sure what time he's going to call me at, so I'm going to have to bring this with me to the hospital just in case he calls. yeah, that's about it. It's going to be a busy enough day. Dickie's arms. Weird. How are you?
Good.
You feeling better?
Yes. I talk to your own.
Well, you need to talk to me.
No, you talk to your own.
No?
Talk to your own.
You're not going to talk to me. Why are you here?
Talking on.
Are you feeling better?
Yes, talking on.
Right. Alright, it is Saturday. Jaden's still in hospital. Jenny stayed with him last night again. He's been kept in again tonight, so I have to stay with him tonight. So, it won't be any different. It'll probably be still no guitar stuff done. Did a tiny bit last night. That was about it. I just wasn't in the fucking mood for it. Yes, Saturday, so I'm going to have to start working on the vlog then tomorrow. I didn't even do last week's vlog yet. It's just still sitting there. I did not even do it. This thing is slowly falling apart. I've really got to get on top of that Sunday as well. Anyway, right. Talk to you in a while. It's going to be a long evening. So this is my bed for tonight. Alright, so I just sent Jenny down to get me a phone. I just can't last here without a phone tonight, for at least the internet. There's no way I'm buying another iPhone, fuck that, so I'm just going to get a cheapish smartphone, that'll do. It's pointless having 500 or 600 quid in a phone. So with Jaden in the hospital, I didn't even get a chance to do the kind of end of week talk. So I'm kind of just picking up some old footage here that I had on the computer. And just going to do my kind of end of week talk over it. This footage, actually, I completely forgot I had it. This was a 2006 American Legacy I had a while back. I was in the middle of trading for other guitars and I managed to get my hands on this. I'm so sorry I sold this guitar, it was amazing. It was really unusual because somebody replaced the fingerboard and actually got a Dublin luthier, Derek Nelson, to do it. A bird's eye maple fingerboard was put on it, and of course 24 frets, which was very unusual. Jumbo frets on it as well, which was nice. It had Kinman pickups as well, and actually the bottom tone was a pickup blend. It was a very, very cool guitar, and I'm kind of sorry it's gone, but I was kind of after an ESP Kamikaze at the time, and I sold this, and geez, I think it was a Yamaha SG2000, a 1977 Yamaha SG2000, which was a real pain. But anyway, yeah, when Jaden was in the hospital, I got no guitar stuff done because I was kind of going to bed kind of late enough. If I did manage to kind of play a little bit or just kind of take my time doing something, and then having to get up the next morning early and go over and spend the day in the hospital. So it was kind of all over the place for the last part of the week. We're kind of aiming, I think. This 3 months has been a disaster, so we're kind of aiming for, you know, October, November, December, really. So anyway, talk to you next week.